Hello everyone out there, this is Blaben Solutions, and once again I want to welcome you to another wonderful video tutorial. So in today's video I will be teaching you how to design a simple church flyer like this. So without much ado, let's get started. I already have my Photoshop application opened, and here are my resources that I'll be working with. These are my resources that I'll be working with. All right, good. So come to file, click on new, then let's name this church flyer. Let me add flyers. Now I'll be using a width of 17 centimeters and a height of 12 centimeters. All right, now with the resolution I'll be using 300 resolution. With the RGB color I'll maintain it. With the background color I'll maintain it, and I think everything is set to go, so click OK when we are done. All right, so this is our working area. Okay, these are canvas. So the first thing we'll be doing is we'll be adding a gradient to this canvas. So to do that, let's come to the adjustment layer here, click on it and choose the gradient, and click inside this way, double tap this little here, and let's change this color to 930808. Good, so we are going to use this color. Hit, let's go back. So I copy this color. So to copy, just hold and drag this and Control C to copy. So I'm copying the hexa code of this color and I'll paste it back again. And so I click OK. Then when we get here, I'm going to change this to 140, I guess. 140. All right, so yeah, then we are done. Now we can do some necessary editing over here. So you can hold and actually hold and drag this in and out. Okay, so I'm going to say I like this, something like this. All right, so I'm going to click OK for that. Now I'm going to create another layer, adjustment layer for this. So click the gradient here this way, and let's choose the same color. So double click this way, then let's paste in the hexa code that we copied in here. Hit OK. Hit OK for this one. And with this, I can drag this up, but let's choose something like this. Good. So now let me hold and drag this thing either inside or outside like this. Okay. So when you are done, just click OK for that. All right. So now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to import my first image. To do that, I'm just going to come in here to my resource here. Then I'm just going to hold the image that I want. Then I'm going to drag this onto Photoshop. All right, so when you bring it in here, just release it this way, and that is it. That is it. So now hold the shift key with the cursor here at the right corner side. Click and drag outside. Let's do same for the downside here as well. And I think this is okay. So then hit enter when we're done. Good. Now with this, we are going to reduce the opacity. So to reduce opacity, here is where we can do that. So you can choose to click on the drop down and use the roll bar to either increase or reduce the opacity. So with this, I'm going to take this to, I think 16 is okay. Now another way I can reduce the opacity is by, when you get this layer selected, you can just on with your numeric keys on your keyboard, the ones just before the function keys. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3. Now 1 is 10, 2 is 20. So I'm clicking you can take a look at this portion. As I click, it changes. Then everything, so I'm increasing, now I've decreased it. So see how it works? Good. So I'm going to maintain this like this. All right. So the next thing I'm going to do is to import my next image in here. And the next image I have is Sonny Badu's image. Now this is this image, so I'm just going to hold, click and drag this inside. So now that you know how to import images into this, I'm going to fast forward this portion so I import the other images in here so as to save time. So I'll get back to you soon. Alright guys, so welcome back. Now you can see that the imported images behind the adjustment layer, the gradient adjustment layer that we have. So what we are going to do is we want the images to be in front of the adjustment layer. So what we are going to do is we are going to select all these three images and we are going to shift them forward. So to do that, select the first image, hold the shift key and select the last image. Now left click on any of the layer, hold and drag till you get this whitish thing up here like this, then you release it. Now you can see that our images are on top of the adjustment layer. Now I want these image Miss Otabel and Reverend Eastwood Anaba to be behind Sonny Badu. So what I'm going to do is Sonny Badu is going to be, I'm going to, the same thing I did, I'm going to just hold and drag and take it up this way. Good. So that is what we want, right? Good. So I'm just going to increase the size of Pastor Otabel. Just hold and drag this like this portion this way, and we can push this inside this way, and we're going to do same for Reverend Anaba. Good. Nicely. And there you have it. So now the next thing you're going to do is I want to take this portion off. You can see this is a very flat surface. Okay, you can see flat surface. So I want to clear off that portion. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select each of this layer, then I assign a layer mask to it, then choose an eraser to brush to clean off that portion. So with Reverend Eastwood Anaba's layer selected first, what I'm going to do is I'll come here to the add layer mask, then I'll just click add layer mask. Now I'll go to the eraser tool, click on the eraser tool, and I have this. You can see the size of the eraser tool here as 13. You can click on the drop down and increase the size, or you can use the square bracket on your keyboard. So now the open square bracket will decrease the size and the close square bracket will increase the size. So you can see I'm clicking the close square bracket and you can see the size is increasing, and when I click on the left square bracket, the size decreases. All right, so I want something like this. I think this is okay, so just wipe this thing off. Sorry, let's check something here. Now let's reduce the hardness. Good. So you can see something like this, very nice. So you just clean this portion very nicely and gently. Good. So do same for, sorry, this is the layer mask we are working on, so you can clean for the other people. All right. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to select Pastor Mensa Otabel and I'm going to do same add layer mask, and I'm going to just clean this portion off like this, and there you have it. All right, and I'm going to select Sonny Badu, add layer mask, and same thing that I did for the others, same way I'm going to do for them as well, for him as well. So you clean gently. So when you're done, you just select the move tool this way, and there you have it. So the next thing we're going to do now is I'm going to add a text. Now the text bears the inscription, a night of joyous encounter. A night of joyous encounter. So this is a text. I'm going to use a font style Helvetica Inserant and Miraculous Christmas. Okay, so I'm going to use this font style to create a night of joyous encounter. So because it's a text, I'll get back to you shortly. I'm going to fast forward this portion so as to save time, and I'll get back to you shortly. All right, see you guys. Alright guys, welcome back. Now the next thing I'm going to do after the text is I'm going to add a stroke to the text. So I'm going to add a black stroke to the text joyous, and I'm going to add a white stroke to the text encounter. So I'm going to do this. So to do this, with our encounter selected, just come to the effects here, click on it and click stroke. So there's a black stroke here. We're going to change the color to white, so just click here this way and select the white color this way, click OK, and we can increase the color here. So I'm going to maintain the 15. Good, hit OK, and let's make this 25. Good. So now I'm going to do the same for joyous, the same step I took. Click on FX, go to stroke, and now we want a black stroke. So I'm going to just increase the size here to something adorable. This is too much. I think 20 is okay. Then I'm going to let's increase the size of the encounter. Good. Let's put this here this way. So now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just italize the night of and so just something like this. Good. All right guys, so the final thing we're going to do is I'm going to bring a shape tool here this way. All right, so I have something here like this, the shape tool. Now I don't want a fill color, so I'm going to put off the fill color, but I want an outline color of white, so I'm going to maintain this, but this is too big, so I'm going to decrease the size to 2. And I'll hit enter, and there you go. And very good, I have this. So I'm going to type in the direction. So I'm going to put in here the time and the location or the venue, and maybe some call contact. All right, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to fast forward this portion, and I'll get back to you soon. Alright guys, so welcome back. Let's not forget we have not brought in our date, so I'm going to put the date here this way. So I'll go for my shape tool, then I'll draw something like this, something nice, small like this. Then double click this portion and I'm going to type in the header code. So 023E49. Good. So this is the color I want. So I'm just going to reduce the size to something like this. Then shift it. Good. Then hit enter. Alright, so what I'm going to put in here is the date. The date is 28th of March. So I'm going to write 28 MAR. Right. So let me do that quickly. So you go for your text tool, then click in here. So let's say 28. Then another, click on the correct key and let's type MAR, indicating match. So with our move to selected, press Ctrl T to give you the accessibility to click on the control key to give you the chance to make modifications to it, as in to increase or decrease it in size. Alright, so I think this is okay. Hit enter and there you go. Then I can drag this up above a bit, so I can hold and bring a match inside this way. So this is okay, and there you have it. Your church flyer is ready. Alright guys, so this brings us to the end of today's video tutorial. I believe you really enjoyed yourself. If you did, please do me the favor by hitting on the subscribe button and also checking the bell icon so as to be notified whenever I drop in a new video. Don't forget to like this video and share. Your comments are welcome. Until I come your way next time, it is still Blaben Solutions. And I'm out.